Hi there, you're on IGCSE Maths Tutors, and in today's video we're going to present an IGCSE exam question that tackles two subjects, mensuration and number bounds. Now let's look at the wording of the question. A metal cube has sides of 4.5 centimeters correct to the nearest 0.5 centimeter. The cube is melted down and the metal is used to make small spheres. Each sphere has a radius of 3 millimeters correct to the nearest millimeter. Work out the greatest number of spheres that could be made. In order to get this question right, we have to look at the wording. The wording says two key statements. The side is correct to the nearest 0.5 centimeters and the radius is correct to the nearest millimeter. Therefore, we make this table showing the lower bound and the upper bound for the side of the cube and the lower bound and the upper bound for the radius of the sphere. If you are not sure how to get the upper and lower bounds, you can check out the video that I had made explaining number bounds. The link of that video appears now on the screen, and I really recommend that you view this video before proceeding further with the current clip. All right, so the lower bound for the side of the cube is 4.25 and the upper bound is 4.75, and the lower bound for the sphere is 2.5 and the upper bound is 3.5. To make more spheres, we need to get the biggest cube possible. Therefore, we choose the upper bound for the side of the cube, which is 4.75 centimeters. This turns out to be 47.5 millimeters. And we have to get the smallest sphere in order to make the biggest number of spheres. Therefore, we get the lower bound for the radius, which is 2.5 millimeters. Now, we first get the volume of the cube, of the largest cube, which is 47.5 millimeters cubed. And if you work this out on your calculator, you get this number. And the volume of the sphere, of course, you need to know this formula. It's 4 over 3 pi multiplied by the cube of the radius. So since the smallest radius is 2.5 millimeters, therefore we multiply 4 over 3 by pi and then multiply the result by 2.5 cubed, and this gives us 65.44985 millimeters cubed. And finally, to get the number of spheres, we divide the volume of the largest cube by the volume of the smallest sphere, and we end up with 1637.465. But since, of course, we cannot have a fraction of a sphere, we round this number to 1637 spheres, and this is the right answer. I hope you found this video helpful and that it has reinforced your understanding of number bounds and how we use them. If you still have questions, please leave them in the comments section below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Meanwhile, I'll see you again in the next video. Goodbye for now.